गुड मॉर्निंग किड्स, आई एम मोहना रवि, योर कंप्यूटर टीचर. होप यू ऑल आर वेल एंड फाइन, सेफ एट होम. टुडे इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ न्यू लेसन. ओके, न्यू लेसन. दिस इज अ लास्ट लेसन फॉर दिस एकेडमिक ईयर. फीचर्स ऑफ फाइल मैनेजमेंट इज द नेम, ओके, ऑफ दिस लेसन. फीचर्स ऑफ फाइल मैनेजमेंट. फाइल मैनेजमेंट मीन्स वॉट एंड ऑल यू कैन डू विद अ फाइल, वॉट एंड ऑल वी रिक्वायर with do action required to do with the file, that is creating, modification and changing the location. Okay, so many is there. Okay, so many is there. So these are all called as the file management. Okay, so let's have a small introduction. You can use Microsoft Word and Paint to create, save, open file. When you have numerous files of different types, you need to organize them. Okay, let's take, we have some paint files, we have some Word file, we have some Excel file, and we have so many types of files in our system, in our PC. So we have to maintain it in a category wise. Okay, folders are used to organize file. So for this, folders are much more way to organize it. Let's take, all the paint files can be kept in one folder, all the Word files can be kept in one folder, like that we can organize it. Okay, you can store files and other folders in the folder. You can see the picture. Okay, you can see the picture. See here, there is one folder, books. Okay, so here whatever the files you want to store it in under this folder, you can store it. Okay, so this is what the example. Then we'll see what is file management. Now whatever I told you, that itself a file management only, but even then we'll read the book content and content also. Meghna has created many files on her computer. Now she cannot find a file she had made on her class teacher. Okay, what should she do? Meghna should put similar files into folder. For this, she has to create, select, copy, move and rename files and folders. This process of organizing files and folders known as the file management. Okay, so what is known as file management? Creating, selecting, copying, moving and renaming the files, called as file management. Okay, the file management will help her easily to locate any files she wants. Okay, then copying a file. You can copy a file or folder to a new location. Let's take, you have one file, okay, in one particular folder. Let's take home. You have a file called home. In you have a folder called home. In that you have a student called file. Okay, now you want to bring that file to your school folder. Okay, so for this will helpful. Okay, this option, these option what I'm going to teach you now, that will be helpful. That is copying a file or folder. You can copy a file or folder to a new location. This allows you to also keep it in its original location. To copy a file or folder from one location to another, follow the steps. Open the drive where the file or folder is located and select it by right-clicking on it. Click on the copy option from the pop-up menu. Okay, from the pop-up menu will appear, in that you have to click on the copy. Then open the drive or folder where you want to copy the file or folder. Just go to that place and right-click and click on the paste option from the pop-up menu. As soon as you right click, pop-up will come. From that you have to select these options. Okay, the file or folder will be copied to the desired location, to the new location where you wanted to save, would have copied. You should remember one thing always: copying is like creating a duplicate. Okay, you are creating a duplicate. Original will be there on the same place where it was actually Okay, and the duplicate also will be created. See, in this picture, here it has copied, and moving a file or folder using drag and drop. You can move a file or folder by drag it from one location to dropping it to the other location. To move a file or folder using drag and drop, follow these steps. Okay. Open the drive or folder where the files or folder is located. Okay, first you open the file or folder, then select the files, means you are just selecting, highlighting it. Okay, then press the left mouse button, drag and drop the selected files or folders to the desired place. Okay, you are just pushing it, you're just pulling it to the new location. Okay, you are just pulling the file, particular file or folder, to the new location. This is called the drag and drop. Okay, then we are going to see renaming. You can change the name of your file or folder. To rename a file or folder, follow these steps. Select the file or folder and right click on it. A pop-up menu appears. Select the rename option from the menu. Okay, as soon as you right click, pop-up will come. In that, you have to choose the option called rename. Okay, type a new name that you wish to give to the file or folder. Press the enter key. That's it. Okay, you just type the name as soon as, and you type in the name, you give the save button, automatically this would be saved. Okay, that is called renaming. Then deleting a file. How to delete a file? You can delete a file that is no longer useful to you. There are many ways to delete a file or folder, but before you delete something, make sure that content is in the file not useful now. Okay, also do not delete the file or folder created by others. Okay, so it means like you are deleting your own content only, you are not deleting the other content. Okay, for which you have to use the delete key. Okay, the easiest way to delete the files and folder is by using the delete key from the keyboard. Okay, from the keyboard you can use the delete key for this. Okay, then to delete the files and folders, okay, to delete the files and folders, follow these steps. Select the files and folder you want to delete. Press the delete key from the keyboard. The delete file dialog box appears. Click on yes if you want to delete the file and folder. Click on no if you do not want to delete a folder. Okay, means you are giving delete key, it will ask you a dialog box. A dialog box will come, it will ask you a permission. In that permission, you are just giving yes or no. If you want to really delete, so give yes. If not, give no. That's it. Okay. Then using the pop-up menu, to delete the files or folder using the pop-up menu, follow these steps. Select the files or folder you want to delete. Right click on the files and folder. A pop-up menu appears. Click on the delete option from the menu. To delete the file dialog box appears. Click on yes if you want to delete, or click on no to the cancel deletion. Okay, this is your right clicking it. You are selecting, right clicking, selecting the option called delete. Then the same way it will ask you the permission. In the permission, if you really want, give yes, or if you don't want to delete, give no. Okay, that's it. Very simple. Okay, then using the organize menu. Okay, when you are viewing a folder, you can use the organize button to delete files or folder. To delete files or folder using the organize menu, follow the steps. Locate the files and folder you want to delete. Click on the drop down arrow of the organize button. A drop down menu appear. Click on delete from the menu. The delete file dialog box appears. Click on yes if you want to delete, or click on no to cancel. The same way as we did previously, the same way you are doing it. Okay. Then tampering with files of others. It is incorrect to pick up someone else's notebook without permission. Similarly, it is incorrect to tamper with files belongs to someone else without permission. Tampering includes opening, moving, renaming, and deleting files without the owner's permission. Means owner means who has created this file, okay? Without their permission, we are not at all supposed to touch and open and viewing the files, okay? It is very bad habit, and viewing itself a bad habit, then changing them, it is not at all, we should not do, okay? So that's it. Then a computer can have files belongs to others, okay? Belongs to other people. You must only work on your own files. You would not like it if someone tamper with your file. You have a right to keep your work to yourself, okay? You may share your files only when you choose to, and you must respect this right of others over their own files, okay? Means just now I told you, you should get a permission to look into their file, okay? If not, we are not supposed to, not even touching the file also, okay? So we should behave wisely when we are in common system. Okay, kids, I think we have come to the end of the session. For this lesson, whatever notes I have to send you, everything will be sent to you. Okay, everything will be sent to you in the WhatsApp group. Okay, then you will copy all the textorial content in textbook and only the question answers in your classwork. Okay, I hope you all would have understood the lesson well. We will meet in next class. Okay, kids, bye.